fascinated by this. I do not have children. What is this new? Walk me through it.
Well, the basic idea, it sounds kind of crazy, but babies in a certain way are born 3 months before they're really ready for the world. In other words, their heads get so big they gotta be born, otherwise they're gonna be too big to come out. And so your job those first 4 or 5 months is to hold and rock your baby. And even if you do that 12 or 14 hours a day, that's a ripoff, you know, for the baby's point of view compared to what they had before. It turns out everyone knows if you rock and shush babies, drive them in the car all night long, they'll sleep an extra hour, rock in a rocking chair. And now we've created the technology, not just to imitate the womb experience, but it's a responsive baby bed. So it hears when the baby cries and actually increases motion and sound, imitating an experienced caregiver. So we're able to add to the baby's sleep, we're able to calm crying oftentimes in under a minute, and we're also able to sleep train babies so that we're, by 5-6 months, you don't have to go through a cry it out routine. Most importantly, as you can see the little wings on that sleep sack, they attach to the sides of the bed, so we prevent the baby from rolling over, which is the number one risk associated with infant sleep death.
Well, I want to talk a little bit about how your technology differs from some of the other things on the market right now. Namely, you have scheduling naps, you have breastfeeding and timing. How does your technology sort of differentiate itself?
Well, really, all those are struggling to take a baby out of their natural environment, which is the womb, and make them exist in a very bizarre world. Consider inside, they're constantly held, rocked, and shushed every single second of those 9 months. Then they're born and we put them on the back in a quiet room, in a flat, not moving bed, looking up at the lights. It's a very abnormal position and posture for the babies. And because of that, they wake up much more frequently. So when you imitate the womb experience and when you do that responsively, we've demonstrated, we've analyzed the sleep data on over 7,000 babies. It's the largest sleep study ever done. And we're able to increase a baby's sleep by 1 to 2 hours at a significance level of 0.0005, which scientifically is the highest level of proof you can imagine. Part of the goal is sleep, but part of the goal is also to prevent problems that are associated with the lack of sleep. Postpartum depression, infant sleep death, obesity, car accidents, marital stress, billions of dollars of healthcare cost, and billions of dollars of employer cost because of poor productivity, poor retention, errors and accidents, and healthcare costs. So who knew that crying little babies and sleepless parents really led to billions and billions of dollars of impact on our economy?
Well, doctor, you know, we talk a lot about advanced technologies. Walk me through how you're also now incorporating cloud, AI, machine learning now into your products.
Sure. Well, the bed, of course, is based on a sophisticated algorithm so that it's able to respond to the baby's need in real time. But our goal is to have the bed respond to each individual baby. Right now, parents can change settings to modify them because children don't just, you know, sleep better and better and better. It's hills and valleys. They go through colds and growth spurts and teething. And so the bed has to adapt when the baby is going through those transitions. So right now, parents can do that through the settings, but ultimately we'll have that through AI. And we're collecting the largest data set on infants that's ever existed in humankind. So we'll be able to analyze that and look for other evidence of issues, problems, illnesses. It's a very rich data set to examine.
Talk to me quickly. How is the funding environment? Who's investing in your company?
Yeah, we've been oversubscribed every round. So what's so great is that the investors, so many of them are young parents. They're familiar with my work and they're familiar with the stress of dealing with exhaustion. So we've had in our Series B, our last round was Google Ventures, Greycroft, Bulb Capital out of Basel. But we also have Lux and Obvious and Felicis who joined us on the A round.